this is a story all about how our life got flipped, turned upside down. And we'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. We'll tell you how we overcame this COVID nightmare. In Brandon, Mississippi, born and raised on the internet where we spent most of our days. Binge watching, eating Zoom and all, cooling all, filming some TikTok since we were in school. When then that's a little virus, what's up, it's no good. Starting spreading COVID in our neighborhood. We got one little case and our moms got scared to say you're staying in the house for the rest of the year. We thought it'd be gone when the school year came near, but the virus said no and it is still here. If anything, we could say it's going nowhere, but they said, nah, forget it, go back, but beware. We pulled up to the school about 7 or 8 and we yelled to our parents, yo, home, smell you later. Look at our kingdom, we was finally back at Brandon High School with Jermix and Matt.
What's up, BHS? I'm Haley.
I'm Sarah.
I'm Ethan.
And I'm Destiny. Welcome to the Fresh News of Brandon Senior Edition. This week's episode is a senior-only episode. That means everything in this episode will be related to seniors, since it's their last few weeks here at Brandon High School. With all that being said, let's get started with some local and national news.
While we have no idea when the coronavirus pandemic will end, the kids around the world are steadily trying to spread happiness. Day of class, a 9-year-old boy spread happiness around his neighborhood by playing piano in his front yard for anyone who's happy to stop by.
Last week, the Food and Drug Administration, along with the CDC, issued a recommended pause on the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine after 6 rare cases of severe blood clots were reported on 6.8 million recipients.
A dad from the coast of Mississippi experienced a blood clot after receiving the Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine. His family said he has been left paralyzed on one side of his body and unable to talk after having a stroke.
That's terrible news, but luckily, he's been admitted to the Oxnard Hospital, which is a great hospital. The doctors and nurses have attended some of the best colleges in the country.
Hopefully, we can all be part of a successful story one day. Although being a doctor seems like it would take a long time, and I bet going to college to become a doctor costs a lot.
Yeah, Haley. It may seem expensive, but many nurses and doctors receive scholarship opportunities. There's actually many scholarships available to people from all parts of the world, even Brandon, Mississippi. Let me tell you about a few of our friends who recently received scholarships.
I applied for METP and Lucky Day at Ole Miss. I accepted METP at Ole Miss.
I applied for the Tennessee State Academic Scholarship and the Farm Bill Scholarship. The Tennessee State Farm Bill and the Academic. Right now it's Tennessee State. Nursing with a minor in agriculture.
I'm so proud of all the Brandon students who receive scholarships. Now that we talked to a few people about scholarship, let's move on to college acceptance. Here's just a few places that Brandon seniors will be attending next year.
I got accepted into Southern here, AMDA in Los Angeles, University of Southern California, Bowdoin College in Maine, Vassar College in New York, UC Santa Barbara, Irvine, and Riverside. I plan on double majoring in English literature and theater acting.
I've applied to Hines, either psychology or psychiatry.
I've been accepted to Hines Community College and Bellhaven. I'm planning to major in diesel mechanicry or automotive body shop, collision repair.
So I've applied to Howard University, Clark Atlanta University, Hillsides College, Mississippi State, and Southern Miss. All of those I just listed. I plan on majoring in marketing or business administration.
And those are some pretty impressive colleges y'all got into. Congrats! Graduating high school is a very exciting and memorable event for all students. It's a time in their life where a new chapter begins and they start to become independent adults. A time like this calls for some celebrating, though.
It does indeed. I can't wait to celebrate with my friends and family. Speaking of celebrating, let's see how other seniors are celebrating their graduation.
I am going to Texas with my friends for our graduation trip.
So basically, as soon as we get the chance to make sure that it's not gonna rain that day, we're gonna go up there. I'm just gonna walk up, get my diploma, be like, yes sir, and I'm strutting out this school, because it has been a long 12 years, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm very excited to pursue college and go into my engineering field and just have a great time with that. So I'm gonna make the most out of it.
Okay, my family is not from Mississippi, we're from Chicago. So everybody from Chicago finna get down here, and we go out to eat, we finna have a big old party at my house.
So my family coming in as well. We're gonna rent out a hotel room, you know, maybe two. One for the adults and one for the, you know, the kids, so they can have fun together. And we're just gonna have like a big little sleepover and invite some friends over. And we'll just, you know, stay there for the day.
Have a couple waters, sodas, you know, the good stuff.
I'm celebrating graduation by going to the beach with all of my friends.
That sounds exciting, Sarah. Hey, why don't we see what our news team classmates have to say about us before we take off to college?
I'm gonna miss Haley because she's very down to earth and very nice. She does a lot of work for us, and we just got her back in here since she was online, and we didn't get enough time with her.
What I'm gonna miss about Ethan, I mean, he's a very good friend of mine. We get along real good. Every time we're in here, laughing, talking, getting work done. But honestly, I'm just gonna miss his drive and his attitude towards everything and how he is in different situations. Even though sometimes he is a little weird, but he's still a close friend of mine and I miss him.
I'm gonna miss Destiny whenever she graduates because she's very sweet and positive. And although I don't see her that often, every time she does come into class, we always joke around and her smile just makes my day better. Sarah is a character. She's very creative and kind, and she helps out whenever she can. She's good-hearted and has good intentions in her actions. That's what I'm going to miss most about Sarah.
Ethan, he is very kind and trustworthy. He always gets the work done, and I'm really going to miss having him around to help us out because he helped us out a lot this year.
Ethan is a very unique person that always brightens my day. I feel like he's very optimistic and I can definitely see him being successful in his future.
I'm going to miss being a part of BHS News and being a part of the BHS community. I have learned so much these past few years and cannot wait to see what journeys life takes me on next. Let's see what other seniors are going to miss about school the most.
What I miss about BHS is like the community, the people, like a few teachers, and you know, just the good vibes that come from this school.
Sheesh.
My best advice is to have fun. Don't let anything hold you back. And stay smart. Don't be dumb. Don't make dumb decisions. Please don't make dumb decisions. But that's about it.
One thing I will miss about BHS is the connections between teachers and the students. Over my years at BHS, I have been able to form one-on-one connections with my teachers, and I know that they'll be willing to help me with anything I need help with. One piece of advice that I would give to incoming seniors is to stay on top of your work. Even though senior year is supposed to be your easiest year, it's easy for it to get away from you.
One thing I'm going to miss about BHS would definitely be the teachers, specifically like my sergeant and my colonel for JRTC. They have helped me through so much. I just don't know what it's going to be like navigating life without them. I'm really going to miss them. And a piece of advice I would give to my, I'll say juniors, because I'm technically a junior, but I'm graduating early, would probably be to I know it's really tiring right now. Do not quit while you're here. Like, you're already here. Don't just stop. Like, let's just keep going and finish strong.
I'm really going to miss hanging out with my friends when I graduate. But seniors, remember, you need to make these last few days count the most.
Exactly, Ethan. Graduation will be here before we know it. So with that being said, our teachers have a couple more things to say to us before we officially graduate.
I will miss their enthusiasm, their positive attitudes, and really just all of the ones I taught in particular. I love you guys. Y'all have my heart. You know that.
I am most gonna miss the free spirit and interaction of this senior class. It is a new experience and fun experience every day. And if I could give them one piece of advice, I would say always work hard in whatever you choose to do and you will be successful.
The class of 2021, what I miss most about them are their leadership skills, how you can just give them a task and they'll run with it and make sure it's complete and done to perfection. Live life to the fullest. Make sure you enjoy life, but don't rush it. There is time for everything.
The first piece I'm going to give you is advice leaving Brandon High School and going out into the quote-unquote real world. I want you to continue a relentless pursuit, not only in your happiness, but also to set up your life for your family and your family after that. What am I going to miss about the class of 2021? I'm going to miss your individuality, your happiness, and your return to normalcy no matter what challenges came in front of you. Good luck and go Dawgs.
What I will miss most about the class of 2021 is how willing they were to work hard and to listen while I taught. If I would give them one piece of advice, it would be to never stop learning. And by that I mean read books, okay? Even when you don't have to, especially when you don't have to. Read 30 books a year at least for the rest of your life. It will serve you well.
Thank you, teachers, for the heartfelt goodbyes and good wishes for what our future have to hold. Destiny, take it on.
Well, I guess that means it's time to say one of our final goodbyes to our friends. But since goodbyes are sad, we are just going to say hello to our new adventure soon to come. And well, that's it for the Senior Early episode of BHS News.
If you have a story, idea, or topic you want covered on the Freshmen to Brandon, email bhsnews@gmail.com or talk to a news team member.
I'm Haley.
I'm Destiny.
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Ethan. Thanks for watching the Fresh News of Brandon.
Hey, that's our hand. I'm sorry.